Hey, folks, welcome into some WNBA action on 2K Sports. And tonight, we'll see the Dallas Wings as they go up against the Connecticut Sun. This is Blake Suniga alongside Tim Swartz and Brian Benefitemi, and we're excited for some 2K Hoops. Well, we normally don't play favorites here, but I'll let you guys play them just this once. Do you have a favorite player to watch?
I absolutely do, and it's Sabrina Ionescu. Not just because she's from my hometown, Walnut Creek. She has total command of the game. She's a triple-double machine. Plus, Sabrina always plays the game with incredible flair.
I mean, who doesn't like watching Ionescu play? I really enjoy another point guard, Skylar Diggins-Smith, a little older than Sabrina. Skylar has that clear point game as well as the ability to score, a lethal combination.
Now here is Hayes.
Takes the three. Tries again.
And Bonner lays it up and in.
Very active on the O boards. Bonner with some second chance points. That's a huge bonus for the team.
Pass to Howard. High post, Kuia. Dangerfield with it.
Six to shoot.
Back to Howard. Yes, and it's Crystal Dangerfield picking up the assist.
Well, that's the decisiveness you need to have on catch-and-shoot jumpers. Howard doesn't really second-guess her shot attempts.
Here's Heidemann.
Sinks that one from the post.
And just a huge hole in the defense, and she didn't waste any time going through it.
Pass to Kuia. Now here's Dangerfield.
And again, it's Dallas with a three.
A great possession. Kuia working it to the wide-open teammate. I mean, that's a nice trip down the floor.
Bonner outside. Allen with it.
Howard's there. Allen's shot is off.
Well, I'm going to say the defense got pretty lucky right there because she's going to make a lot more of those than she misses when she gets that much room.
She is one of the best when it comes to making the sweet lead pass.
Now Heidemann. Pass to Hayes.
This one for three. Now in the scoring column with that deuce. One for two this game.
An offensive powerhouse. When Hayes is feeling it, she has the range to stretch the floor.
Here's Agumbawale. Goes up. And again, it's Dallas converting.
And that's just a very good high percentage look right there.
Here's Heidemann, guarded by Dangerfield. Now here's Allen. Pass to Heidemann. Now Hayes. And another three for Connecticut.
Takes pride in each performance. Hayes is the centerpiece of everything her team does.
Agumbawale with it. She's guarded by Hayes.
Outside Agumbawale.
Back to Dangerfield. Howard.
And again, it's the Wings from deep.
How about that? Responding to the three-pointer against them with a quick one of their own.
Yeah, terrific little back and forth right there, Tim.
It's been a lot of fun to watch.
Here's Heidemann. Outside for Thomas. Here's Hayes. Buries it down low.
Well, when you've been in this league as long as Hayes, a little bump, I mean, it's not going to affect you at all.
Pass to McCowan. Good, and the assist goes to Crystal Dangerfield.
That's how to orchestrate for your teammate. Terrific pass.
Bonner outside. Three-pointer. And another three for Connecticut.
Such an unselfish player. Bonner is one of the best passing forwards in the WNBA, constantly looking to get everybody involved.
And when you talk about veterans aging gracefully, Dawana Bonner really stands out.
Still such an effective player. She hasn't had one season where she averaged less than double-figure points per game. Just continuing to get it done.
The Sun trailing. And here's Heidemann.
Pass to Allen. Thomas with the ball.
Here's Hayes.
And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim.
They can't afford to give her that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you have to fight over the top of it.
And you need some help as well.
Now here's Kuia. She hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Agumbawale from long range misses that one. Her first miss of the night, 2-for-3. And it's good. The game is all even.
A crafty left-handed scorer. Hayes is always creating new ways to get buckets on opponents.
Agumbawale with it. She's guarded by Hayes. Count that bucket.
Right when you thought that shot was leaving her hands, she reinvented it.
Hayes with it. 12 points for her. Here's Allen. Yes, and a nice assist from Tiffany Hayes.
I'm not sure that was the play they had set up, but it was too good a look to pass up.
And shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Pass to Dangerfield. And they come right back with their own three-pointer.
Answering the three with one of her own, Crystal Dangerfield, playing with fire.
Inside, Thomas. Terrific assist and a nice finish. Just a solid play all around.
But when it comes to size, that's not a great one-on-one matchup for her.
Well, you wouldn't know.
Whoa! She hit it!
Whoa!
Incredible!
Woo! That is how you silence a crowd.
And a high-scoring first quarter. Both teams really filling it up. It's the Wings. They're up by 3. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in a moment. And so far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter going. And looking at what we've seen from the Wings, what do you guys think?
I think the roof is up. But get some people some umbrellas. It has been raining in here. A lot of threes.
Yeah, you know, I'm a huge umbrella guy. But hey, when it rains, it pours. And they haven't let up from beyond the arc.
To the right side. To the paint, and it's going to be a goaltending call here, so they'll count the bucket.
What an alert play. Just a great job of hitting her teammate on the move.
Dallas leading. Pass to Segrist. Outside Howard. And here's Burton. From deep. And she's good on the three ball.
Great to see Howard find her wide open teammate. She continues to develop her ability to make plays.
Hey. Here's Harris. Pass to Brown. The three. And another three for Connecticut.
Right back at you. They immediately get those 3 points back.
Just trading punches from long range.
It's been a heavyweight fight.
Segrist outside. Now Burton. To the inside. Sims. 2 points. That one goes in.
And how about the persistence from Sims? Fantastic at taking contact and still finishing off the play.
Pass to Brown. Nelson Adota. Covered by Segrist. Brown with it. Just 5 to shoot. Over Sims, and again, it's Connecticut.
Great piece of work to get to the hoop. She tore the D to shreds.
Now Segrist.
Hey, eyes up, watch her. Don't get
outside Howard. Pass to Burton. Shoots a three. That falls. Nice feed that time from Natasha Howard.
She's been able to find her open teammate every trip down the floor.
I mean, it sure has seemed like it, right? I mean, great day passing the rock for her.
And Harris gets it to go.
Soft touch around the rim. You don't want Harris to catch you out of position inside.
Pass to Howard.
Segrist. It's Burton.
Brown with it. Fades. She gets that one.
Using her lengthy wingspan to her advantage, Brown is able to dominate down low.
Yo, watch it, watch it.
Now Brown.
Pass to Hattar.
Her shot is good, making her a perfect 2-for-2 from the floor.
Outstanding entry pass. She knew exactly where to go with that ball.
Time called here. The Wings decide to talk it over. All right, here's a question for you two. What type of skill do you think has become undervalued in today's game?
Ball handling. We're seeing so many players who can shoot these days, but the real difference makers are the ones with a tight handle.
But I'll go with rebounding. To finish a defensive possession, you have to secure the board. And offensively, you can extend bad possessions with O-boards.
Outside, Agunbowale.
Hey, I'm right
here. Dangerfield outside.
Shoots over Harris. The shot by Dangerfield, no good.
Connecticut trailing.
Down low.
Nelson Adota.
The shot goes down and it gets this game back to even.
A solid distributor. Harris understands her teammates depend on her to get them involved.
Dangerfield outside.
Good, and the assist goes to Agunbowale.
The height difference there was huge, but she canceled it out with great body control in the air.
That body control right there is essential. If you're giving up a bunch of height on flat ground, then you better be good in the air.
And be able to adjust in the air, too. They worked it in nicely right there.
And when you think of Arike Agunbowale, her scoring is the thing that comes to mind immediately.
This is her role, and she does it well. She's a volume shooter who can score from all three levels. And I appreciate how fearless she is.
That is why you put in that upper body work. Maddie Segrist, strong.
And the Sun call time here. Side Hayes. Thomas outside. Three on the clock. Here's Heidemann. It's rebounded by Agunbowale.
The shot was there for her. She had to take it. And I don't care if she didn't convert. She should take it again next time.
Back to McCowan.
Pass to Kuia.
Here's the floater. And the shot goes in.
Wow, that was impressive. Kuia keeping focus despite taking the bump.
Thomas with the ball. Bonner outside. Now Heidemann launches a three, buries the long-range jumper.
That is some dime dropping. Exquisite assist.
Up top, Agunbowale.
She's guarded by Hayes.
Outside, Agunbowale. Oh! And that one goes in as she's fouled. It'll be 3 points if she can convert the free throw.
Exciting, explosive guard with a promising future. Arike is a talented scorer.
She got it!
That counts! Count it!
Just in time.
A miracle heave to finish off that quarter. How'd she get that to go down?
Fantastic shot.
And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half.
It's the Wings leading by just one.
Stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter going.
Well, you know, Dangerfield has been exceptional here.
She had the magic touch in terms of setting up her teammates, just a pile of assists for her.
Which isn't a very common occurrence for her. You know, typically she's more of a finisher, but that's just not the case in this one.
Come on, watch the cover.
Pass to Heidemann
for the lead. Connects from three-point range.
Perfect screen there. Set her up with a terrific look.
Yeah, but that's a bad job by the defender to not fight through that screen to contest.
You want to see more effort there.
Out.
To the middle.
Ogunbowale, good.
The D has no answer for Ogunbowale, which is why she keeps getting the ball and capitalizing.
Hey, yo, right here.
Here's Heidemann, guarded by Dangerfield.
And it's in.
Hard to get that shot off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for her, especially down low in the post.
That's a big challenge she's taken on. Going in there with the bigs, great job.
And there it is.
We talk about players drafted and entering the league in the late 2010s. Arike Ogunbowale is one of the few who still uses the mid-range.
Ilana Bonner for three. And another three for Connecticut.
That type of D, it's just not going to cut it. They got to get a hand in her face. Too good of a shooter.
Outside Howard.
Pass to Dangerfield. That falls. Nice feed that time from Natasha Howard.
Only took them a few seconds to answer the three ball at one end with their own.
A three-point battle starting to take shape here.
Hayes with it. Shoots the three. It falls for the sixth time in seven tries this contest. That's an 86% accuracy mark.
Dangerfield outside.
Makes it off the glass.
Playing way bigger than her listed 5'5 height. Dangerfield playing the game with passion.
Hey,
pass to Hayes.
Thomas, McCowan defending.
Here's Allen. Solid play on the low block, and that one's good.
The second she got around the pick and shook her man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy deuce. Very well done.
Outside Ogunbowale.
From downtown, and again, it's Dallas with a three.
On D, Arike Ogunbowale is about as tough to cover as anyone. When she's hitting threes, it's a nightmare.
Pass to Thomas.
Here's Allen.
Rejected by Tierra McCowan. The floater. And Ogunbowale laying it in.
For any under 6 foot guard like Ogunbowale, the teardrop is a must. Allows you to score over bigs in the paint.
Pass to Allen. From past the arc.
A rebound by Crystal Dangerfield.
Dallas leading. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing in control.
Here's Howard. And the rebound goes to the Sun. Stolen by Kuia. That one drops for her.
Well, you go back to the steal by Kuia. Her quick hands, long arms, igniting the break.
Pass to Allen.
Bonner.
Here's Heidemann.
Thomas, right side.
Here's Heidemann.
Guarded by Dangerfield.
Tiedemann, no good. Here's Dallas now.
Yeah, 4-point game.
Well, no doubt, Tierra McCowan is the best offensive rebounder in the league.
Well, leading the W in offensive rebounding percentage in each of her first 4 years. obviously, I mean, being 6'7 helps McCallum, but beyond that, she is so smart at reading misses, getting to the right place, reading the rim.
Number three, Tiffany Hayes. Count that one as her seventh make in 8 attempts. That's a scorching 86%.
Pass to Kuia.
Shoots over Bonner.
And it's Kuia missing.
And if they play the clock right, they can go 2-for-1.
Just got to time it up right.
Bonner, good.
Good D, but guess what? Bonner's height at 6'4", coupled with her touch and leaping ability, make her dangerous down low.
The shot's good. And here is Heidemann. 11 points in the game. 8-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Thomas, and she floats it in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one.
With the ability to score from difficult positions, Thomas is dependable when her team calls her number.
Here's Ogunbowale. Through the net again. She's done that 10 times tonight, and she's only needed 11 shots to get there. Here's Heidemann. Here's Thomas. Using the post moves to get the 2 points.
Well, that level of toughness should energize Thomas's teammates. She invites contact from opponents.
And the game's still closely contested as we end the third quarter. Sun ahead, leading by a point. And time for a short break. Stay right where you are. The fourth quarter is coming up next. Got a great game on our hands as we welcome you back. Fourth quarter action getting started. The wings trail. Pass to McCowan. Now here's Brown. She's covered by Thomas. Now Ogunbowale. Clock at 6. Dangerfield with it. Shot on the wing. The rebound by Harris. Thomas outside. And 2 free throws coming up as she misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. Kalani Brown picks one up.
A bulldozer going through the lane. Thomas is durable over the course of a basketball game, and she's constantly in attack mode.
The first one falls.
Playing overseas, Alyssa Thomas was named the 2023 Defensive Player of the Year in Europe.
Well, you know, her all-around offensive game gets a lot of headlines, but Thomas is a menace defensively, especially just her smarts. Her defensive IQ is off the charts.
And good on the second, so she makes both. Here's the wings with the ball. They trail by 3. Pass to McCowan. Now here's Ogunbowale. To the inside. Here's Brown. And that's off the glass and in.
There has been zero effort on the defensive end by both these sides.
Well, the criticism is deserved. This high score is more a product of poor defense than great offense.
It's just been awful on that side.
Here's Allen. And there's the foul. It's on Thomas. That is her first foul of the game.
Well, it wasn't a textbook pick, but she still managed to score. And I'm a fan of that concentration on the finish.
And the wings call time here. Now here is Sims.
Pass to Kuia.
Shoots from the line. And the rebound goes to the Sun.
Now Heidemann. Here's Allen.
Let's it go from deep. And the Sun hit again from deep.
And they are just killing them with the three-point shot here in the second half.
Yeah, and the defense knows it. They are fully stretched out there trying to stop the three and still haven't been able to do it.
Yeah, I don't know defensively what they can do different at this point.
Misses the basket. That puts her at 5 for 9 from the field. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Outside, Agumbawale. Yes, great play by Odyssey Sims to set it up.
Scoring off the ball. Agumbawale so active on this end.
On the wing, Rebecca Allen. Heedman, she's covered by Sims. And that one drops.
Well, tired legs affect you at the defensive end first, and that's what's happening here.
You nailed it. And as much offense as we saw early, we're seeing even more of it here late.
Here's Brown. And Dallas again with the bucket.
You have to be mentally strong to not just take, but make the big buckets. Brown's able to come through for her team.
And here's Heidemann. 5 on the clock. Pass to Harris. The 3. And another 3 for Connecticut.
Well, guards like Harris need to be able to stretch the floor. And there, she does.
Dallas calls timeout.
Well, they want to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and now's the time to do it.
Yeah, there was clearly some things going on out there that the coaching staff just wasn't a fan of.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. We've played just over 3.5 minutes now in this fourth quarter. Out to Howard. Out to the right wing. Here's Dangerfield. Yes, for basket number 9. She's missed only 2 shots from the floor all night.
With a great sense of the moment, Dangerfield is a winner, and you love to have that trait in your lead guard.
And the Sun call time here. Harris with it. Pass to Hayes. Here's Thomas. Here's Allen. Can't get it to go. Her fifth miss in 10 shots from the field. Agundawale. She's guarded by Hayes. Now here's Agundawale. Tight defense on him. Here's Howard. And there are the Wings with another bucket.
The bigger the moment, the bigger Howard plays. Remember, in the 2018 finals, she had 29-14 in the clincher.
Now here's Harris, guarded by Dangerfield. Now here's Harris. Four on the shot clock. Harris for three. And again, Connecticut no good. Dallas trailing here. Outside Howard. Agundawale. Stolen by Harris. Bonner outside.
Sinks it! With mental toughness and focus that grows throughout the course of a ball game, Hayes simply is a professional whenever she steps on the court.
Agundawale with it. Guarded now by Hayes. And Agundawale gets it to go.
Just a fearless competitor. It's obvious. Arike Ogunbowale loves taking over during important possessions.
Thomas, she's covered by Brown. Fades back. Count it!
And with that basket, you'd have to think this lead is safe.
I don't know if I'd call it 100% secure, but at least 98%.
I'll go 99.2.
And the Wings call time here. Your thoughts, guys?
They not only need to draw up a score here, but a quick one.
And once they get that quick strike, there has to be an immediate foul.
Yeah, Brian, they can't waste any time.
Agundawale. It's good! And she has brought them within 2 points.
That is who you want taking the big shots. Arike Ogunbowale has that it factor. Wants the rock in pressure spots.
Timeout called, the Sun. Foul intentionally, and they're gonna have to do it again. They're not in the penalty yet.
Yeah, they had to do that. You just can't let them dribble it out.
Definitely. Got to stop the clock any way possible and just hope they short arm a few of their free throws.
It's a good foul, and it's a good point in this situation to make them hit their shots.
She hits the first one, and that makes it a three-point lead. And so she drops them both, and it's a four-point ball game.
Now that's how you close a game out. Those free throws will bury them for sure.
Now here's Agumbawale. She's guarded closely. And there's the intentional foul. No choice but to stop the clock here.
Two.
So the first one drops, and that puts them up five.
Developing a strong work ethic at a young age, Hayes has always been about the grind and not the fame.
And so both free throws good this time. And it's a six-point ball game. From deep, no good. So we get to see the Sun get the win here. This one was up for grabs right until the dying seconds.
And you know, I think what stood out was they showed their character when it mattered, doing what had to be done to send these fans home happy.
And that's a wrap, everyone.